Welcome all of you in this tutorial of decision tree. In this tutorial we see basic theory regarding the decision tree. So first of all we see the types of decision tree. Decision tree having two types: categorical variable decision tree and continuous variable decision tree. Decision tree which has categorical target variable, then it is called categorical variable decision tree. It is also called as classification tree. Let's see the example of student which play cricket or not to play cricket, which having target variable yes or no, then it is called as categorical variable decision tree, nothing but classification trees. And another type is regression trees, nothing but continuous variable decision tree. Decision tree has continuous target variable, then it is called continuous variable decision tree. Now let's see how decision tree looks like. Decision tree looks like this. This is the root node, this is the decision node, this is the splitting, this is the terminal node, root node. It represents the entire population or the sample. Then it further gets divided into two or more homogeneous set. Here we can see these are the two sets, and this is the splitting. Splitting in the sense, it is the process of dividing a node into two or more subnodes. Here is a branch. Branch is nothing but a subsection of entire decision tree. This is called a branch or a subtree. In this branch we can see it here is a parent node, nothing but decision node, and this is a child node, then terminal node. So while we going for decision tree, there is a problem of taking decision about variables regarding which variable we can choose for taking decision. So for that we use Gini coefficient. Gini coefficient gives us the priority of variables regarding the target variable, which variable we choose as a decision node. First of all, let's see what is Gini coefficient and how it is calculated. Gini coefficient is calculated by using the formula p square plus q square, where p is nothing but probability of success and q is nothing but probability of failure. While calculating Gini coefficient for split, using weighted Gini score for each node of that split, we use weighted Gini score, nothing but Gini coefficient. Also we can say it as also Gini coefficient. So let's see one example regarding students. We have example of 30 student, and we try to classify it by using two variables. We use first variable is gender and second variable is class. Class is nothing but 9 class and 10 class student. So let's see the example. Here our first variable is gender. By using gender we try to obtain Gini coefficient for this gender variable. We have 30 student, out of which 15 play cricket. So we divided by using a gender female and male, out of which 10 which contain, out of 13 there are 10 female and 20 males. Out of 10 female 2 play cricket, and out of 20 males 13 play cricket. So we are going to obtain first of all Gini for subnode female. For that we obtain the probability of playing cricket, which is nothing but p, which equals to 0.2. And here we can say we see that play cricket 2, that's why 20%. So nothing but 0.2, yes, p is 0.2. As a formula of Gini coefficient is p square plus q square. Here is a p square, 0.2 multiply by 0.2 plus again q is nothing but 1 minus p, that is 0.8. 0.8 multiply by 0.8 equals to 0.68. Now again Gini coefficient for male subnode, then here is a 13, nothing but 65% of overall. Then we, it is nothing but p is equals to 0.65. Then 0.65 multiplied by 0.65, nothing but p square plus q square. Q nothing but 1 minus 0.65, which is equals to 0.35 square. Answer is 0.55. Then overall weighted Gini for gender is, here we use 10 female, here is a 10 female, that's why 10 divided by overall स्टूडेंट्स 30 मल्टीप्लाई बाय जीनी फॉर फीमेल 0.68, देन अगेन प्लस 20 मेल्स डिवाइड बाय ओवरऑल स्टूडेंट 30 मल्टीप्लाई बाय जीनी फॉर मेल 0.55 इज इक्वल टू 0.59. दिस इज द रिक्वायर्ड जीनी कोएफिशिएंट फॉर जेंडर्स वेरिएबल. Then again, our second variable is class, 9 class and 10 class. Let's do same process for the this variable, class variable. Here is a 9 class student, total 14 9 class students, and 10 class student, total 16 10 class student. So let's see, do genie for 9 class student. Then out of 14, 6 play cricket, that's why you use, that is 43%, that's why use 0.43 as a p. So p square plus q square, q is nothing but 1 minus 0.43, answer is 0.51. now we do same process for class 10. Again we got gini at 0.51. then weighted gini for split class is 14 for class 9, 14 divided by overall student 30 multiplied by gini for class 9 plus 16 divided by overall 30 multiplied by gini for class 10 0.51. then our gini coefficient is 0.51. as you see, our gender gini coefficient is 0.59 and gini coefficient for class is 0.51. as gini score for split on gender is higher than split on class, that's why we use gender coefficient to split our target variable. First of all, the first priority to for our decision tree or decision node is going to for going for gender variable, then we use class variable. That's why this is the one process for obtaining the decision node, the decision variable for our decision tree. Again we also use another method, which is nothing but entropy. So let's go for entropy. Entropy can be calculated by using formula: minus p log to the base 2 p minus q log to the base 2 q, where p is nothing but probability of success and q is nothing but probability of failure. Entropy is also used with categorical target variable. It chooses the split which has lowest entropy compared to the parent node and all the split. Lesser the entropy, better it is for the decision. So lesser entropy, we choose that variable for our decision. So let's see how entropy is calculated for same example. So here total students are 30, out of which 10 are female, 20 are male. Then this is the entropy for parent node. Parent node nothing else but overall student. So let's see, we see that here we have total out of 30, there are 15 students play cricket. That's why p is nothing but 15 divided by 30. So our formula is minus p log to the base 2 p minus q log to the base 2 q. So minus 15 by 30, nothing but 15 play cricket out of 30. That's why minus 15 by 30 log to the base 2 of p minus q log to the base 2 of q. Answer is 1. Our node is impure, that's we have to, our node is impure, therefore we have to divide it, we have to split it. So for we split it by using a gender variable. So split is nothing but female or male. For now entropy for female is, here play cricket is 2 divided by 10, overall female students are 10 and out of which 2 are playing cricket, that's why p is nothing but 2 by 10. Here we use p is 2 by 10 log to the base 2 again p minus q, q is nothing but 1 minus p, q log to the base 2 q. This is the 0.72. 0.72 is the entropy for female node. And again for same thing for male node, nothing but 13 divided by 20. So minus 13 by 20 log to the base 2 13 by 20 minus 7 by 20, nothing but 1 minus, here is q, q is equals to 7 by 20, that is 1 minus p equals to q log to the base 2 7 by 20, that's 0.93. this is the entropy for male node. Now we calculate overall entropy for gender node, gender variable. That is nothing but 10 females to 1 divided by 30 multiplied by entropy for female node plus for male 20 divided by 30 multiplied by entropy for male node, nothing but 1.93. So overall entropy is 0.68. Again we do same thing for class variable. Here is class variable. Here is entropy for parent node is same because of total out of 30 we select 15 students to play cricket. That's why our parent node entropy is 1 and it is impure. That's why we are going to split it. So entropy for class 9th is, here is 6 divided by 14, that means p is equals to 6 divided by 14 for class 9. So minus p log to the base 2 p minus q log to the base q is 0.99. So entropy for class 9 is 0.99. again for same thing for class 10, again the entropy is 0.99. so overall entropy for the split of class is 14 divided by 30 student multiplied by entropy for class 9 is 0.99. again 16 divided by 30 multiplied by 0.99 is entropy for class 10 node. So overall entropy is 0.99. so lower the entropy, better the variable for decision. So here entropy for gender is 0.86 and entropy for class is 0.99. so we use gender variable first of all to take decision about our target variable. Then after gender variable we use class variable to take decision about our target variable. So priority for taking decision about target variable is for gender because of its entropy is lower than that of class variable. As we see in Gini coefficient, we have for that we also use gender coefficient as a decision node first of all, then we use class variable for our taking decision. So may all of you like this tutorial. So thank you all of you.